Beautiful morning, Chuck.
Beautiful.
Beautiful? What's beautiful about it?
Why, the mountains and the lakes and trees.
Oh, cut some bacon.
I'm starved. Fella sure gets an appetite up here. Bet you're sorry you invited me. I've just about eaten you out of this fire station.
Why, that wolf gets on my nerves.
It sure is a mournful song.
What's so exciting?
Just a deer.
Some deer.
Come on, give me those glasses. I saw her first. Hey, look at your flapjack.
Oh, darn the turn.
I wonder who she is.
Wouldn't be surprised if Laura Morton's sister.
Well, I hope you're not hurt.
No, I'm all right.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But I might have been if you hadn't pulled me out of the water.
Well, that's all right.
I do thank you.
Maybe I ought to introduce myself. I'm Jim Turner. I'm staying with Chuck Foster, the fire warden.
Oh, yes. You're the man that studies plants and talks to animals. And,
I'm that nut. I guess you know all about me.
I suppose I should introduce myself.
Laura Morton's sister. Been away to school for 4 years. Just returned and,
And you know how old I am and, in fact, everything about me.
No, not everything. Only as much as Chuck Foster could tell me.
Did he tell you that I'm sitting here drenching wet and freezing?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Jill, darling, I told you Fangs mustn't have any milk. Daddy won't have any left for his coffee.
Laura, Mr. Turner.
How do you do?
I'm very glad to meet you, Mr. Turner.
And her husband, Joe.
Howdy. How are you?
And his partner, Pete Taylor.
Oh, we met before out in the woods.
You look like you've been out in a storm.
We were. But thanks to Mr. Turner, I wasn't drowned.
What happened?
He'll tell you all about it while I get out of these wet things. Won't you stay for breakfast, Mr. Turner?
Well, I'd love to, but I had an early one.
I'm very grateful for what you did.
Including the ride?
I'll be right back.
Oh, there's that eagle again. If you'll excuse me now, I'll go and help Marge.
See, Joe? That half-breed dog's running with the wolves again. Tell you, you better get rid of that dog before he goes completely wolf and hurts somebody.
Well, I guess I better be getting along. Chuck will wonder what's happened to me. See you all later.
You know, I don't like that fellow.
Oh, forget it, Pete. Come on, let's go down to the pelt house.
Well, Pete, I guess you're kind of glad Marge is home again, aren't you?
Wouldn't you be? She gets more beautiful every year she comes home from school. Now she's home for good.
It's about time you took some interest in a girl and settled down.
Oh, I've had that idea for a long time.
Yeah? What does she say about it?
You know, I usually get what I go after.
Maybe you do, but I wouldn't always be too sure as far as a woman is concerned.
Well, you wouldn't help a fellow, would you?
Didn't say I wouldn't, did I? I can't seem to find those silver fox pelts. I wonder what happened to them.
Oh, they're around here someplace. We'll find them.
I hope so.
Mother bear and her little cubs fishing.
Mm-hmm.
baby one. He caught a fish.
Beginner's luck.
Marge.
Yeah?
I want to show you something. It's a surprise. Well, what do you think of it?
What am I supposed to think?
Isn't it beautiful?
Yes, but what is it?
Why, the house I'm building for you.
House?
Our dream house. I'm gonna make it out of logs. And there's gonna be a great big fireplace, a great big stone chimney. Oh, and right over on that point there, overlooking the river, that's going to be my den.
Oh, but I want a sewing room there.
Oh, no, that's a perfect spot for a den.
Oh, but I must have my sewing room.
Well, along the path, I'm going to have Caspinola Caparta.
In good old English, exactly what does that mean?
Canterbury bells. Blue. Match your lovely eyes.
Here you are, Blackface. I deliver it. Same as usual.
Ah, sending a letter by airmail again, eh?
My special bird messenger.
Hey, haven't you cut your throat yet?
No, but if I was you, I'd worry about my own.
What do you mean by that, Crack?
Well, I hear that Joe Morton's partner, Pete Taylor, is planning to marry Marge.
Well, that may be a little bit exaggerated.
Well, I'd look out, Jim. Pete Taylor's not the man to take the loss of his girl sitting down.
Yeah. I think I get what you're driving at. Thanks, Chuck.
Well, I always said, no matter what a woman brings to a man, trouble's bound to be part of it.
Marge, your friend's here again. Oh! Thank you, Blackface. Listen. Let's see how the house is getting along today. It's from him.
I know who it's from, but what house?
Well, it's a house we're building on the side of the hill, overlooking the lake. It's just a dream house now, but...
I know. That's the way Joe and I built this house.
Morning.
Oh, good morning.
Say, Ned Hawley's giving a dance at his place Saturday night. Are you going with me?
Why,
You're not going with anyone else?
Oh, no.
Good.
Hello,
Joe.
Come on, Pete. We got to get out of the traps.
Well, huh? Goodbye, Marge.
Goodbye.
I'll see you tonight.
Okay. All right, thanks. Be good.
I'm going to kill that beast someday.
Come on, forget it.
Old Nottingham with a drummer man, and he played the tom-toms in the band, but the rawhide rhythm caused his mind to crack. So they locked him up in a padded cell. At the cuckoo house, he's doing well. At everything he sees, he takes a whack. Oh, he thinks he's a great big Indian chief, and he thinks his squaw is Princess Falling Leaf. So he pitched his nightshirt for a tent. Now he goes around with his back all bent, doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. He's doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. He's doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. Oh, he told his squaw this morning to give all his warriors warning.
Quite a crowd.
Yeah, once a year we have a lot of excitement, and oh boy, I'm raring to go.
Big pale-faced guard passing by the door, saw old Nottingham sitting on the floor, and he asked him if he'd smoke a pipe of peace. Nottingham let out a groan. He said he'd do everything he owned for a tomahawk to slay the bloomin' beast. I'd get him scalped to hang in my teepee from the statue of our dear old Liberty. So he grabbed his tom-toms from the floor with a whoop and a yell. He was off once more, doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. He's doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. Doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house. On his tom-toms he starts drumming. He thinks buffaloes are coming while he's doing a war dance down at the cuckoo house.
Let me take your hand.
Thanks very much.
Hello, Jim.
Hello, Marge. Oh, hello, Pete.
Hi, Turner. Save the next desk for me?
Yes, it's yours.
Fine. Say, you're having lots of fun up here.
Just a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Nick Ambrose tells me he has collected enough of his brethren to form a quartet of five voices. I'm in favor of giving the boys a chance. Huh?
Rockin' and ridin', I go along. Rockin' and ridin' and singin' a song. Down that old Rocky Mountain trail. Cedar and pine trees perfume the air. Birds are all calling their mates everywhere. Down that old Rocky Mountain trail.
Lofty pine on the hill seemed to reach the sky. Now and then a little gust of wind goes hurrying by.
It's early in springtime, snow's almost gone. I'm rocking and singing as I go along. Down that old Rocky Mountain trail.
More exciting than sitting up there looking for fires.
As far as I can see, this is the quickest way to start one.
How would you like some punch?
I'd love some. I'm thirsty.
I'll get it.
I want to go with you.
All right.
Hello, Mrs. Holly.
Oh, hello. I wonder if you'd help yourselves to the punch. I'm having an awful time fixing these ice cream cones to take upstairs to the children.
Oh, let me take them to them. I'm going up to see Jill anyway.
Well, if you want to.
Thank you.
Oh, Marge. Don't forget the next dance.
I won't forget.
All right, folks, get your partners for the next dance.
Hello, baby. Hello, Jill, darling.
Look what Aunt Marge brought you.
And this is for little Jill. And here's one for you.
What's the matter? Oh, Aunt Marge's going to give you a nice big ice cream cone. You want some ice cream? There.
Ice cream
for you.
Is that good?
You eat your ice cream.
I want.
Mm-hmm.
I want to watch the baby? All right. Here, baby. Is yours good, Jill? Now, you take this in your hand, like that, and eat it. Goodbye, babies.
Turner's fallen in love with Marge.
Yeah, Pete said he's going to put a stop to that. You know, that fellow's liable to catch himself an accident and not get home.
Don't be ridiculous, if you don't see the silliest thing.
This is our dance, Marge.
I'm sorry, Jim. I promised this dance to Pete.
Oh, you'll excuse us, won't you, Turner?
There isn't someone else, is there?
No, you know there isn't.
If I thought that you were...
But there's no one else.
Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have thoughts like that.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
One of my best specimens. What's the idea? All right. All right, I'm sorry. Shake. Come on, Jim. Shake.
Atta boy.
Marge.
Hello, Jim.
How are you?
I'm all right. You're quite a stranger.
Keeping pretty close to the station. Getting behind in my work.
But you haven't been here since.
No. I haven't had much time for it. Air castles.
But it was amusing. Don't you think? Well, Jim, goodbye.
Bye, Marge.
You got the count on the boxes, Pete?
Not yet.
Well, according to my reckoning, there's 20 skins short.
Oh, that can't be, Joe.
There's 20 skins short. What have you done with those skins?
What do you mean?
You stole them. Come on, Pete. Where are they?
Take it easy, Joe.
This isn't the first time I've been watching you.
You don't know what you're talking about. You can't say
that. You stole them! You're a thief, a dirty thief!
Joe!
No doubt the dog committed this deed. The marks of his fangs and the clawing of the body are sufficient evidence. That is the finding of this inquest.
Allow me to extend my sympathy, Mrs. Morton.
Thank you. Come, dear.
Sheriff of this county, I'm declaring the dog Fang an outlaw. I'm putting a bounty of $100 on his head, dead or alive. Henry, see that notices go out.
Do you think it was Fang?
I'm afraid so.
I can't understand it. It isn't like him.
Is there anything I can do for you or your sister?
No, thank you, Jim. There's nothing more.
Well, there ain't no doubt but what that wolfhound done.
I warned you about that beast.
We'll have to find that dog.
And kill it.
Thank you.
There's a fire. Section 9.
All right, I'll be right with you.
Where are you going, Pete?
I'm going to save what I can of my belongings.
Anything we can do to help you?
No, I can take care of my own affairs.
Then I'm ordering you to come and help us fight the fire.
I've got my own to save.
I'm commanding you to come. I'm the fire warden, and I've got the authority. Now, come on.
Carrying it south. It's spreading towards Topa Topa. I hope nothing happens to him.
He'll be able to take care of himself.
But I mean, I know who you mean. He may be trapped in the ranger's cabin.
Well, when you take this coffee to the men, perhaps you can find out.
All right.
Thank you. Are these all Morton had?
Yeah, that's all.
Tragic the way he met his death.
Yeah. Well, I warned him about that half-breed dog. The beast is gone now, though, destroyed in that fire we had.
Fire was pretty bad, wasn't it?
Well, bad enough to spoil trapping for a while. I may have to go over on the other side of Topa Topa this winter.
Did you ever think of training eagles to do your trapping?
Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I've read of foreigners. If they can do it, I can do it.
Hello, Pete.
Hello, Ned.
Say, Wilkins. I just came over to make sure you were coming by my place.
We'll check in there as soon as we're finished here. And just check that over, Mr. Taylor. How's Pelts, you see?
Well, they're in good condition this year.
The check's okay.
Right.
Blackface? Here, that Turner fellow's gone.
I don't think anyone's gonna grieve over him.
I guess not. Well, I gotta be gone, Pete. I'll be seeing you.
Okay, Ned.
Now, Jill, you can go out and play.
Well, we made the count, Laura. Everything's okay, and here's your check.
Thank you, Pete, for this and everything that you've done.
Oh, that's all right. Just think of me as one of the family. Maybe I will be soon. Well, I got my money today. We've got plenty now to be married on.
We'll talk about that later.
I'm going up in the mountains to get some young eagles. I've got an idea.
Be careful, won't you?
Don't worry about me. See you when I get back.
All right.
So long, Laura.
Goodbye, Pete, and thank you.
May I come in?
Hello, Jim. I'm glad to see you again.
How are you?
Fine.
Is Marge here? Is Pete around?
No, he's gone to the mountains. Did you want to see him?
Yes. I had something very important I wanted to discuss with him.
Well, you came back, eh?
Hello, Pete.
Well, I might as well tell you now to stay away from Marge.
Pete!
Oh, that's all right, Marge. I don't want any trouble, but
trouble.
This
one... Should have thought of that when you hid that skin.
What are you talking about?
I found it, if that means anything to you.
Oh, so that's where my pelts have been going, eh?
You doing too much talking, Taylor?
Why, are you...
Pete! Don't! Tell me what all this means.
I'm sorry, Marge. I can't. I was wrong in coming here.
Yes, I guess you were.
Telephone the valley people. Oh, don't cry, Laura. I'll get some of the boys. We'll get her back.
There's Joe and now the baby.
Some of you men know otherwise. We've got to get up there.
Let's get started, men. Even now, we may be too late.
Dale, look. You stay here, will you? Chuck Foster's phoning the valley people, and as they come up, you send them on to the search.
Thank you.
Well, which way now?
Right up the face of that cliff.
Yes, I heard about it right away. I've got my deputies with the searchers.
Do you think they'll find you?
I figure they will. But I'm looking for Pete Taylor.
He's gone with the searchers.
Nothing for us to do, Benson, but wait till they get back. Thank you, Miss Marge. We'll find him later.
Goodbye, Sheriff.
Goodbye.
Jill! Jill, are you all right? Oh, sure you are. Boy, we're gonna take you home to Mama. Good boy, come on here, Frank. Atta boy.
Any news of the baby, Holly?
No. But we found Pete Taylor in the river, dead.
Dead?
Yes. That half-breed dog killed him.
Here he comes now.
Jill! Jill!
She's all right.
Oh, Jill!
She's all right. Just a few stretches.
Oh. How can I ever thank you enough?
That's all right. Don't thank me. Thank Fangs. Some dog.
Hello, folks.
Howdy, Sheriff.
Hi, Sheriff. Have you told him yet?
No, I was just about to, and...
Well, men, I think you ought to know about this. Jim here found a blood-stained pelt in Pete's storeroom and took it to the police. They found human blood on the fangs and claws of that pelt. But that doesn't matter now because Pete's dead. And so, it wasn't the dog after all.
Jim.
Marge.
I knew I'd find you here.
I've been waiting here every day for you. Marge. I'm sorry for any unhappiness I've caused you.
What about our dream house? Won't you please finish it?
Will I?